Information. We all like information. I want to make sure that we know that we have lots of information when it comes to understanding what it means to live for God. We're going to be looking at 2 Peter. I'm going to be talking to you about what that means here in just a second. But first of all, just thanks for watching. And we're going to enjoy what we're going to be talking about this week as we learn that God has given us what we need. As we look to Peter's second letter, he gives us a brief introduction, verses 1 and 2, and then he moves into verse 3, and he's going to be talking about what God has given us. This verse, verse 3 of 2 Peter chapter 1, is going to be our key focus verse for this Sunday. We're going to be covering other verses as well, but this verse sets the stage because we need to understand that God indeed has set us up for going in the right direction for him. So speaking of God, Peter says this, his divine power has given us everything we need for a godly life through our knowledge of him who called us by his own glory and goodness. His divine power has given us everything we need for a godly life. This Sunday, we're going to be talking about this. God has given us everything we need. Sometimes we feel like we're coming up short. Sometimes we feel like we've been shorthanded. Sometimes we feel that God has not given us enough. We listen to the commands of Scripture. And we see how Jesus takes those and boils them down to love God and love your neighbor. But even still, with those reduced commands, those summarized commands into those two grand statements, sometimes we still wonder, how do I actually live my everyday ordinary life for God? How do I pull this off? What does it look like to actually live for God? Often it's not that we don't have the desire to live for God. Sometimes that's the problem, and that's a whole other issue altogether. But sometimes we have the desire, but we simply don't know how to do it. And Scripture makes clear, particularly here in verse 3, that God has given us everything we need in order to do so. So I encourage you to come this Sunday and make sure that you come ready to learn that God has given you everything you need. So we will leave our Sunday worship time knowing how to do it. It's going to be up to us to actually execute that, to live that out. But we're going to come and be equipped by the knowledge that God has given us through his word. So hope to see you then. Let's go find out what it looks like to have everything we need to live for God.